Hello everybody, in this quick video I will show you how I put a transparent text on an image in Photoshop. Like this, this, or this. So let me show you how to do this in Photoshop. We start by opening a project and we add a background picture. Or we can start by opening an existing picture. Here I will use an HDR picture I made a couple of years ago, the Roman baths in the UK, in the village of Bath. I make a new layer, I fill the layer with white, I set the transparency to around 60-70. Next step is to add the text we want to put on top of the image. So I select the text tool and I start typing my message. Here I will simply use Roman bath. We color it black. We put it central in the frame with Ctrl A or Command A on a Mac, selecting a line vertical and a line horizontal to the center. I use Ctrl D to deselect. The next step is to group the text layer with the white layer. We can do this by hitting Ctrl G or Command G on a Mac, or use the menu Layer, Group Layer. In the group, we select the text layer and we right-click to open the blending options. We are going to knock out the text by selecting Shallow and we set the fill opacity to our liking. And look what we got. To get good readability of the text and still a good view of the picture, there are several options. We can blur out the background a bit, for example with directional blur. We can make the white rectangle layer smaller, so you can still see the image clearly and read the text at the same time. Or we can add a drop shadow, for example, to the text. Always pay attention when you overlay text on an image, because you are sacrificing two things: image clarity and text readability. For example, in this picture, placing text on a less complex area in the photo will automatically improve the readability, like we did in this picture here. Putting the text on the water keeps the subject of the image, in this case the building, still visible. Adding a drop shadow or a stroke effect to the text will increase the readability in photos with more complexity. Try to play around with the text design and see what combination works best for your chosen image. For example, changing the opacity, changing the stroke, for example, the drop shadow, and so on. Here are some extra examples of possible variations for the three selected pictures I used in this tutorial. If this short video helped you in any way, do me a favor, let me know in the comment section below. And I want to ask you the question of the day. How many times have you already used transparent text on an image? Let me know in the comment section below and share your experience with others. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell, and see you in another video.